Hi there, Joe. Yes, Mufi Hannemann joining me now. Some disappointing numbers, but still an optimistic outlook for you.
Well, you know, I'm so blessed that I have some of the greatest supporters and friends and family in the world. And I really feel this campaign is something we can hold our heads up. We define the issues. We set the policy for the whole discussion and, of course, this debate. We have been singled out as winning every debate. Unfortunately, people just don't vote on debates, or not enough people saw that. So it is what it is. But I'm hoping that Governor-elect Ige and Lieutenant Governor Tsutsui will take some of our ideas and suggestions very seriously, because it was all about the people who came forward with these suggestions and recommendations.
What are some of those ideas that you hope they take?
Well, save our state hospitals, for one. We need a public-private partnership. Let's do something about reducing our electricity prices, the highest in the nation, and think very seriously about bringing the Inter-Island Ferry back. People want choices, they want options, and I believe those are three critical issues that will go a long way to satisfying people's concerns, and that's what was resonating during the debates.
Now, your supporters and even longtime friends say that it was a different Mufi this time around, one who was kinder, one who really listened to the people.
Well, you know, I think I've always been that way. It's just that when I've taken positions in the past that I felt very strongly about it, and I illustrated it perhaps in a way that people felt like, wow, you know, is that the only way to do it? So this time I really tried to be a lot more sensitive to people's concerns and the like, and that's why we were able to, I think, get some people to start paying attention. I'm very happy that this campaign has been characterized as one that took the high road. This campaign was characterized as running we had a textbook campaign, and you know, we didn't have the kind of money that the major party candidates. We were outspent over 10-1, and we didn't engage in any negative advertising. It was just positive. It was principle before politics. It was people before the parties.
Now, Dr. Ruth Ono, your second mom, said on stage that there's always tomorrow. You're a never-give-up kind of guy. What does tomorrow bring for Mufi Hannemann?
Well, you know, that's what moms are for. I have a blessed mother who's left this good world for another place, and now Ruth Ono has stepped in very beautifully to fill that void. You know, I'm plenty busy. I'm a private consultant. I run a nonprofit leadership program at the Pacific Century Fellows. I write a column. I do a radio show. I give scholarship awards. I have plenty of things to keep me busy and make a difference. We'll just have to see what tomorrow holds. The main thing is I want to get back to my wonderful family and my friends and supporters and spend some time with them, because I took them through a very difficult journey, and the odds were against us, but they stuck with me through thick and thin, and I'm very blessed for that.
Will you leave the door open for another campaign?
Well, you know, in life, you sort of just go through, and I've always been a guy that I want to make a difference every time I try to do something, and we'll just have to wait and see.
So not saying no.
I'm not saying no. I'm not saying yes.
And you did mention up on stage that you really tried to convince people to make a change, to think differently this time around.
Yes, I did. And, you know, that's what I've always been about. I've always been a no scare 'em, go get 'em kind of guy. And I just think for Hawaii, it's just going to take a little while longer for them to get beyond, you know, just thinking of things a certain way. And, you know, we need to change. We need to, you know, stop kicking the can down the road. We need to tackle some of these issues here, take it head on, and do it in a collaborative manner. And that's what I've always been, somebody who can work with Democrats, Republicans, business, and labor. And so I hope that that's one of the lessons learned for all the victorious candidates, that that's what we got to do. Don't do things because of partisan politics. Do it because of the people.
Any other message to your opponents in this race?
Well, once again, I want to congratulate David Ige and Chan Tsutsui, both gentlemen that I've known for a while, and I respect the wishes of people. They elected Chan and David and wish them well. Also, hats off to Jeff Davis and Duke Iona for running good campaigns. I think we gave the people a very good campaign, because there were more debates, more forums than ever, I think, in the history of Hawaii in any gubernatorial election. Unfortunately, we didn't have the dollars to drive home that message, and that's where we were lacking.
Your last words on stage to your supporters were, don't worry, be happy. Anything else you'd like to say to them?
Don't worry, be happy. Keep your head up. We ran a great campaign. We've been commended for the way we ran our campaign. Clean, honest, issues-oriented. We did it for the people, and that's something to be very proud about.
Thank you so much, Mufi Hannemann. Nice to see you again.
Thank you very much.
You know, showing how kind he is, I'm not really this tall. And, of course, everyone knows he's not really this short. He's so nice. He stood below the riser, and I'm here on the stage just to be honest with you. Thank you so much again, Mr. Hannemann, for joining us.
Thank you very much.
Back to you in the studio, Joe.